we kind of like wanted to take that old school sound and turn it into 11.
Kind of. Nice Spinal Tap reference.
Hey everyone, I'm Belgian Jasper, welcome to the channel. If this is your first time, click subscribe right now. After 7 years, folk metal icons Finntroll are back with an amazing new album called VREDESVAVD. I think I pronounced that correctly. To talk about the album and everything that has happened in the last few years and everything that the band is planning for the future, I'm talking to the drummer Heikki Saari, also known as Mörkö. Heikki, congratulations on VREDESVAVD, the release, the new album. It's already entering the charts in many countries. That's pretty cool. How are the reactions so far for you?
First of all, thank you. Media attention is all right. And actually, I was going through some data on how these albums have been performing. You know, I was VREDESVAVD like 7 years ago, and how about that? Because I'm a data nerd anyway. So I went through that, found out that actually VREDESVAVD have already covered 20% of all the BlueSpec streams on Spotify for the past 7 years. I don't know if it's normal or not. I don't have any data to where to compare it to, but it's fun to, you know, compare this little. We actually hired a social marketing professional to help us out with this post and, you know, go through and when to post what kind of material. And it's been working great. We got some good attention in there, really, really good buzz around it. So
So you hired the right person.
Yeah, of course.
It's been a while since the last album. It's been seven years. It's not that Finntroll was not active during that time, far from it. You joined the band right after the last album. What was the reason that it took 7 years to create a new album?
Yeah, you're correct. People were asking, like, are you guys have been, you know, like having a break or something? Definitely not.
No, and, we're playing everywhere.
that's true. And I think the process started already like 4 or 5 years ago. And that's when the first riffs came out.
Okay.
You know, first riffs and first, you know, 30 seconds or 1 minute of the songs. And we just, like, every now and then when we were touring or playing shows, we'd listen to the songs and just, like, have a conversation that, is this the direction that we want to go, and what's wrong with this song, and what's wrong with this song, and, you know, and it just took a while, and there was no progress, and like, real progress, and there was no connecting points between the songs. There were like a lot of different ideas, and we needed to do something. So we battled the issues, and we decided to continue touring. Actually, after that tour being so successful, surprisingly, we actually toured Europe twice around this concept, and then tried composing again. It didn't work. So we did what Finntroll does the best, and that's tour again. And not only this, we did a lot of festivals and did also South American tour, like Brazil and Colombia, Mexico, and whatnot. I think at some point the band was all ready to break up. Like, really, we had a lot of, you know, conversations like right after the shows, and this, we want to do this, we want to keep touring, and we want some new music and whatnot. We had like a lot of discussions and arguments about like different demo versions of things and what to be changed and blah, 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 blah. Especially me, I was like really, really bored about this, of this, all these conversations and whatnot. I was just like, I don't give a shit about what songs are they, who's composing what parts are where, what kind of style of music we want to do. Let's just book the studio and go. At some point, Matthias just sent an email to Century Media and like if he can book the studio. And this was end of 2019, a year ago. And this kind of like got the process moving. And I don't know what happened, but like, and personally, I'm not a fan of like kind of deadlines in creative process, but this time it somehow worked. We somehow managed to find the red thread between the songs, and this is how we gave birth to VREDESVAVD. I have no idea how this took 7 years, but I'm just happy to see it done. But it was a lot of work.
I think it might just be my favorite Finntroll album, and that is because it's extremely cinematic. It's, you know, it's big, but it's also, you know, maybe one of the more extreme albums that Finntroll has ever done. And throughout, it feels very diverse. And so when you're talking about, you know, we weren't really sure what style we wanted to go to, for me, it almost sounds like, oh, you know, we've been away for 7 years. Now let's make sure that everybody remembers all the different things that we can do. What was the inspiration for the people behind all the songs? Because it is a very diverse album.
Yeah, that's a good question. And also what we actually wanted to achieve. And we wanted to make like an album that kind of like combines the old gloomy black metal-ish elements.
And
still has these like uplifting melodies and stuff that actually are like part of the Finntroll style. The biggest point was, at least for me, was to like remind the people that Finntroll is a serious band, and the stuff we do from our hearts, and we wanted to make like wanted people to understand we are, you know, there's more of Finntroll than those like funny drinking songs.
You've been with the band for quite some time now, almost 7 years.
Yes.
But this is your first album for all the reasons that we just discussed. How is that for you now to experience this, the cycle and the craziness that is a Finntroll release?
I'm going to start with that drums are a big part of the sound of this band.
Like, yeah, especially this album.
Yeah, that too. And some of the previous drummer, he was a big part of this Finntroll sound, in my opinion. When I joined the band, I didn't want to copy his style. That's not my way of working, you know. But instead, like, evolve my own playing somehow to match the Finntroll sound. And that was interesting and took some time. To understand what this band is all about, you know, you can always practice the songs and just play the songs, but that's not the thing. It's like I've always had this kind of like technical approach, and even though I don't, like, you know, keep myself as a very technical drummer, but still, now it was like kind of like time to take all this technical stuff and everything you learn and just put it to garbage and just figure out something totally different. And this is what I wanted to achieve, like somehow just like take and respect the original sound of the band and just like kind of like create my own, put my own energy in it. And when joining this band, I learned that this band has like unbelievable capability to follow whatever the drummer is doing. I don't have to worry about if I fuck up, for instance. Let's say we're in the middle of song, I'm doing this epic drum fill. And epic drum fill means epic fuck up. So this means that the song would go like or something like that. But the band would be straight on point. Like,
okay.
All the time, every fucking time. I don't know how they do it, but they're like, they are so like trained to follow what the drummer actually does.
Was blackened folk metal. I mean, I don't really know what the best way to describe Finntroll is, but like the bands that you were a core member of were very different from Finntroll.
Mm-hmm.
So were you already into that, or is this more something that you kind of learned to appreciate as you joined the band?
Yes. it's not like, if we look back like 20 years, I've played drums like forever. And I come from like totally different kind of music. I played like when I was a kid and younger guy, like 17 or 18 or something. I was in the pop or soul and funk and rock and this kind of stuff. And metal music just came in like later. So I've always been like open and into like different kinds of music, mainly, you know, whatever sounds good to me. Sometimes it's not even that. I just want to play music. And when I like get to play different kind of stuff and adapt myself to that feel, that's exactly what happened with Whorion as well. You know, that was first band ever that I actually had to really play like death metal blast beats and fast stuff. And yeah. I took it as like a challenge. I was like, oh guys, this sounds good and you're playing good. Why the hell not? Yeah, just started practicing that kind of stuff and found out that would be really fun until a certain point.
So does that comment, does that mean that the Orion story is over, or
is there still
something happening?
It's another creative process, let's put it like this. And extreme music requires extreme practicing. The last album we did was like five years ago.
Yeah, 5 years ago, yeah. So
actually, when that came out, we already had all the songs ready for the next album.
Okay.
Started practicing it, and but then came all the other challenges. Like I was busy with Finntroll, that affected something, and we started practicing. At some point, we started to record the actual album. We just like decided, okay, we just start to work and record the album, and let's see what we come up. I think I have two songs to record. One is something that I want to redo, but other than that, it's all right. To me, getting these Whorion songs, you know, flow good, and so that I feel comfortable, it requires a lot of work. And that's something that, even though if I'm working with Finntroll or touring with Wintersun in the States or whatnot, I still have to work on that Whorion stuff, because that requires different kind of technical approach in my playing. I thank you for having me here, because this is one of those things that keeps me, you know, motivated, keeps me building stuff, because, you know, doing all these mic setups and doing all these streaming setups that I've been working on lately and whatnot, setups and everything for the drums, so...
So the way that my ego listens to what you're saying is that in a small way I helped the next Whorion album forward.
I really think so, because, you know, maybe we get it done at some point, but I'm not, you know, setting any
expectations.
Yeah, any expectations on it. But.
Yeah. When you joined Finntroll, you took the name Mörkö. Bing translator told me that is Swedish for dark island. What's the meaning behind that band name?
This is an interesting story. When you join a band like Finntroll, you have to have like this artistic name.
Yes, and artistic ears as well.
Yes, correct. And like you said, Mörkö translates to dark island. Yeah. First of all, in Swedish, is the island part of it.
Okay.
And that's a direct translate from my last name, which is...
Oh, okay.
How we came up with this was, we were all kind of like, all kinds of like bad ideas about, you know, artistic names while having beer behind. And Finntroll being two language band and Finland being a two language country. And now that you know that, translates to my last name. So we started looking through all the bus stops and metro stations in Helsinki that have in them, like Brände or Nuutio, and now everybody who lives in Helsinki, they will laugh their asses off. Surprisingly, this didn't work, and it didn't return any positive results, except for the very, very horrible hangover. So I started Googling around islands in places in Sweden, and I actually found out that there's a place in Sweden called Mörkö, and also Mörkö in Finnish is some kind of a boogeyman.
Okay, there you go.
So, very, very long and bad joke. It's like many other Finntroll stories, like a lot of beers and bad jokes.
Okay, a lot of beers and bad jokes. That's the tagline for the Finntroll story. Yeah. While still taking the music very seriously.
Yeah. And
talking about, you know, Swedish words, VREDESVAVD is Swedish, again, according to Bing translator, to me, weaved. What is the meaning behind that title?
So all the stories on the songs are connected some kind of a journey or travel to certain locations or journeys onto your own mind, like spiritual journeys or whatnot. All of these stories are somehow connected to hatred or wrath. And that's why these stories kind of like make the album like wrath movement.
Yeah.
All
connected by the underlying reason of people's journey, if you will.
Yeah, kind of like something like this.
Cool.
We're a live band. Many bands do these like streams and stuff, because of the COVID restrictions and whatnot. But we're not the band that find it comfortable.
Yeah.
At least there would have to be like a real live show and live audience and all this, because that's why you do it. Otherwise it would be a practice.
Yeah.
So we're really, really hoping and counting on the spring tour to happen. And if we have to cancel, then we might need to, you know, figure out new strategy but I don't know what would it be. Like I said, we're a live band. Some of the guys are literally going insane if we don't get to on stage like soon. Yeah. If everything goes as planned, there will be like 60, 70, 80 shows for next year. But
yeah, it's a tough situation to be in, for sure. Yeah. Everybody watching this interview needs to keep their eyes open on everything that new social media marketing manager is putting out.
Yeah, and of course. If it happens so that there's no shows whatsoever in the next year, then we most probably want to still do something. But I'm not sure if it's a, you know, live stream or DVD
sure.
or like re-record all songs or whatnot. That would be cool though.
Yeah, well, it would be cool for sure. I mean, there's plenty of classic material that the new lineup could give a very interesting twist to. So
yeah,
that would be cool
true.
For sure. A couple of anniversaries coming up. Or a cover album. There we go.
Yeah.
What would be a song that you would love to cover?
Oh man, I don't know. that's a hard question. I think one of my favorite cover songs ever is the Metallica cover that Finntroll did before I joined the band. It's fucking excellent.
Well, I mean, you grew up with, I mean, sorry, not grew up with, but you started your career playing, you know, soul and pop music.
Mm-hmm.
Could be interesting to see what Finntroll would do with that kind of music and give the Finntroll treatment. Well, Heikki or Mörkö, thank you so much for your time. I really appreciate it.
Thank you.
And thank you for taking this call in your cool new streaming studio that you're setting up. So that's nice to see that as well.
Yeah, basically now that you mentioned it, so I have to do it, because I was kind of like balancing it if I should do it or not.
I can cut it out if you don't want to.
No, dude.
Awesome.
Thanks for
setting
the challenges.
There you go. So challenging you for live streams, challenging you for a new Whorion album. This is
a very
productive conversation.
True.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
I'm glad I'm getting things done.
Yeah, exactly.
You are awesome for watching that video. Click right here to see more content like it and subscribe to the channel.